learned that the Mola artwork were actually embroidered designs that were stitched onto the Kuna Indians' women's blouses. So we saw some examples of the molas, and we could see that there was tons and tons of color and pattern. So what the Mola people did was they focused on color and repetition of those patterns and geometric and organic lines. I just drew a very simple outline of an Asian elephant, and then I'm going to quickly cut that out, and then I'm going to move on to the next step. All right, so once I have my elephant cut out, I can go in and clean up any pencil lines that I have, clean up those edges because we want to not see those lines. Or you could always just flip it over, but I'm just going to erase this line because I want him facing to the left. All right, so once you have your elephant all cut out, or whatever animal you are using, you're going to place it on the next piece of paper that you're using. So I recommend choosing about 3 to 4 different colors and save your scraps. Do not get rid of your scraps because you can use them to fill in other areas around your first picture at the end. So you're gonna take it, put it in the middle, and you're gonna trace around that original image, holding down tight on that center part so that it does not move. Moving your fingers all the way around from one side to the other. So this part is important. Once you have it traced on the second piece of paper, you are going to go in and cut it out, but you're going to cut it out a little bit smaller than the original trace. So I'm going in and I'm not cutting it out on the line. I'm going a little bit further in. And this is a little tricky, so you might need to go back and forth. But take your time cutting it out smaller. Once you cut out your second one, you're going to place it on top, see how it lines up, and then you're going to grab another piece of paper, take that one again, the one that you just cut out, and you're going to trace it once again. So once you've done about 2 or 3 of these, now you can start to do some geometric and organic lines on the inside. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to look at this last shape that I have here. And I'm going to think, what shapes might I want to have on the inside of this guy that I can put there without actually tracing it? So what I'm gonna do is I see a big area right here that I might just fill with a big purple spot. So what I'm gonna do is take a look at it and see, you know, it's probably not bigger than this. I drew a little shape that I know will fit in there. So when you glue your pieces down, you're going to do it layer by layer. So I'm gonna lift up the second to bottom layer and put it to the side. And then I'm going to just do my first one, flip it over, put the glue on the back, and then repeat the process.